الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أن الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن upon the sunnah messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم have informed us about a type of victory, a victory that many people fail to realize, a victory that somewhat become lost in traditions and cultures that stay away from the teachings of Islam. And today, in today's day and age, we often attribute victory and passing exams or being successful or meeting a person's objectives to many worldly affairs and many worldly matters. So you often find people saying, showing extreme pleasure and joy when they pass their exams, showing extreme pleasure or joy as they see their teams becoming victorious in different types of sports. Perhaps they even show success or they show pleasure thinking they become victorious when they've met certain requirements or objectives in this dunya. So you often find when a person reaches a criterion or reaches an objective whereby he finds a new job or he finds a new profession or he meets his objectives in terms of his profits, he'll call himself victorious, or he'll call himself somebody that's passed or met the objectives of success. Whilst no doubt all of these points and all of these avenues are permissible in its original form to show some kind of joy or to show some kind of pleasure due to meeting someone's objectives or some forms of success in these different avenues, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised us a greater form of victory. A greater form of victory that only the true worshippers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are able to comprehend. And thus, they search and they look out for, ensuring to the best of their ability that they are really and truly victorious. Victory in a manner whereby it is not followed by defeat. Victory in a manner whereby one will find pleasure forever. One will be called a person of victory, victorious forever and ever. Victory whereby a person will be successful, and this success that he will find will never be taken away from him. So it's not like the victory of this world, it's the victory of the next life. Hence Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّوَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا يُصْبِحْ لَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. He says subhanahu wa ta'ala that whoever obeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and obeys the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. He has found a victory that is the most mightiest form of victory a person can ever feel, the most mightiest forms of victory a person will ever taste. Victory in al-akhir. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ وَإِنَّمَا تُوَفَّوْنَ أُجُورَكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَمَنْ زُحْزِهَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ فَقَدْ فَازَ. He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, indeed, every single soul shall taste death. And on that day in يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَمَنْ كَانَ sent out on يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَمَنْ زُحْزِهَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ. Whoever is able to save himself from the fire, and whoever enters into paradise, فقد فاز. He is the one who is victorious. وما الحياة الدنيا إلا متاع الغرور. And what is dunya? What is this dunya? Except for small levels of pleasure. Small levels of pleasure. That's our brothers, our sisters in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran has reiterated the point of victory several times. In fact, the scholars of Islam, they mention that Allah jalla wa'ala reiterates the point of victory 16 times in the Quran, informing us that the most mightiest form of victory, or the greatest form of victory, or a victory that is open and clear, is whereby a slave has found al-Jannah. Whereby a slave has found al-Jannah. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ ذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْكَبِيرُ. He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those who believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, and they do righteous deeds, لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ. They are those people who find gardens under which rivers flow. ذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْكَبِيرُ. ذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْكَبِيرُ. This is the most mighty, the greatest form of victory. This is the most greatest form of victory. He also refers to it, سبحانه وتعالى, فَقَدْ رَحِمَهُ وَذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْمُبِينُ. The righteous things of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who fear Him, who worship Him, who obey Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon Him. وَذَٰلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْمُبِينُ. And this is the most open, the most clear form of victory. Our brothers and sisters in Islam, in the fawz, al-fawz al-haqiqi, the fawz, the victory that is absolutely real, the victory that we should all be striving to acquire, the victory whereby Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praises and glorifies, that actually deserves the prostration of thankfulness. The victory whereby we need to spend all our utmost time towards in order to acquire is the victory of Al-Akhirah. Is the victory of Al-Akhirah. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِ فَيَقُولْ هَا أُمْقْرَأُ كِتَابِيَا إِنِّي ظَنَنْتُ أَنِّي مُلَاقٍ حِسَابِيَا فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ في جنة عالية. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that from the points of this victory is when a person gets his scroll on his right hand. And as he gets his scroll on his right hand, he understands that he's from the people of Al-Jannah. He understands through looking at his scroll that he finds a mark showing that he's successful, a mark telling that he's from the people of paradise. He sees his deeds outweigh his bad deeds. He's able to cross the Sirat. He's able to find the intercession of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All of these points, all of these positions, all of these trials, all of these marks are marks of victory for the believer. All of these marks are marks of victory for the believer. فَمَنْ زُحْزِهَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ فَقَدْ فَازَ. Whoever is saved from the fire, whoever is able to enter into Jannah, these are the people. These are the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised victory. Thus people may ask, what are the signs of victory in this dunya? And how may a person be able to understand that he is walking upon the path to acquire the victory? The scholars of Islam, they say, the signs of victory, the sign that you may be victorious in al-akhirah, the sign that you may be from the people that will enter into paradise, the sign that you may be from the people that Allah Jalla Wa'ala sends mercy towards, the sign that you truly are victorious, are of four different angles, or of four different etiquettes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولَهُ. Whoever obeys in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and whoever obeys the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they live their life obeying Allah, they live their life trying to please Allah, they fulfill their obligations, and they go beyond marking the obligations of glory more victory by following the voluntary actions. Obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a sign of victory. Obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a sign of glory. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولَهُ. And following the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and obeying him. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ
فاتبعوني. Say if you truly love Allah Jalla wa Ala, then follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Just praying like him, having his etiquette, having his manners, worshipping Allah Jalla wa Ala, following his sunnah, and establishing his sunnah upon yourself, upon the earth, is a sign of victory. He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَيَخْشَ اللَّهُ. And those people who fear Allah Jalla wa Ala, they fear Allah Jalla wa Ala. Wherever they are, they feel as if though they understand and comprehend that Allah Jalla wa Ala sees them, Allah Jalla wa Ala hears them, Allah Jalla wa Ala knows about every detail of their lives. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu used to say, we the Sahaba, or those people that came before us, the mighty Sahaba, used to see sins like mountains about to crush their heads. They used to fear Allah Jalla wa Ala in the open, and they used to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the private. They used to fear Allah Jalla wa Ala amongst gatherings, amongst people, and fear Allah Jalla wa Ala when they were by themselves. And he says subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَيَتَّقِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَائِزُونَ. And those people who have taqwa, those people who not just don't just fear Allah Jalla wa Ala, but they make sure they go out on this earth, making sure that they place in between them and the wrath of Allah actions, statements, beliefs that can protect them from the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from all types of punishments. He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, هُمُ الْفَائِزُونَ. These are the people that are truly victorious. These are the people that are truly victorious. These are the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless with gardens under which rivers flow. Thus, the victory that is real is not the victory of this dunya. The victory that is real is not the small levels of success and pleasure we find in this world. Even though these small levels of pleasure and success may have its halal side to it. That's when a person finds that he has gathered much profit, or a person is able to marry and have children, or a person finds his children succeeding, or himself succeeding and passing his exams. All these are small levels of success, small levels of victory that will one day be passed with sickness, with loss, with death. That's the real victory, is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls to. The real victory is being able to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروا إنه تعالى غفور. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وبعد، إمام البخاري الإمام مسلم they narrate a hadith in the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, a story about a person called Haram ibn Milhan رضي الله تعالى عنه, a companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that was sent by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to bi'r, to the water or the well of Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala an. And this Sahabi radiyallahu ta'ala an was known to be a reciter of Al-Quran, and he was sent amongst some other Ansari men to teach the people Al-Quran. As he was traveling, as he was being sent by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, some of the enemies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they found him and they cornered him. As they cornered him radiyallahu ta'ala an, from behind him a kafir, a disbeliever, approached him, and he stabbed him with his sword until his sword came out of the stomach of Haram ibn Milhan radiyallahu ta'ala an. Haram ibn Milhan radiyallahu ta'ala an, he fell to the floor as he saw the sword coming out of his stomach and blood gushing out from every possible angle. He began picking up the blood of his hands. He began picking up the blood with his hands. And he began wiping his face with his blood. And he said, radiyallahu ta'ala an, fuztu bishahada wa rabbil ka'ba. He said, radiyallahu ta'ala an, fuztu bishahada wa rabbil ka'ba. by the Lord of the Kaaba, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I am victorious today with martyrdom. By the Lord of the Kaaba, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I am victorious today with martyrdom. And he began wiping his face with his blood until he, radiallahu ta'ala an, he left this world. That's the Sahaba and the generations that are pious after them. They found victory in ibadah of Allah jalla wa ala. They found victory in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some of the scholars of the past used to say, every time they used to worship Allah jalla wa ala, and every time they used to become accustomed to a greater or a new act of worship that they didn't already used to do. So they became from the people that now performed Qiyam al-Layl, or they became from the people that now fasted Mondays and Thursdays. Whenever they adopted a new act of worship, they found victory in it. And they'll say, Fustu bi Rabbil Ka'bah, or Fustu wa Rabbil Ka'bah. By Allah, the Lord of the heavens and the earth, by Allah, the Lord of the Ka'bah, I am victorious. That's so, brothers or sisters in Islam, Inna lil muttaqeena mafaza, hada'iqa wa a'naba, wa kawa'iba atraba, wa ka'san dihaqa, la yasma'una fiha لغوا ولا كذابا جزاء من ربك عطاء حسابا. He says سبحانه وتعالى إن للمتقين مفازا. The believers of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the believers of Allah جل وعلا, those who have taqwa, they are the ones who are victorious. They are the ones who are victorious. They are the ones that will have gardens under which rivers flow. They are the ones that were given حور العين, beautiful women in Jannah. They are the ones that are truly victorious. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable us to understand that true victory is with the pleasure of Allah. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from them. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us victorious in this dunya and in the akhirah. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who are raised of the shuhada, raised of the siddiqeen, raised of the anbiya, raised of the salihin. Allahumma a'izz al-islam wal-muslimin. Allahumma adill al-shirk wal-mushrikeen. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. قوموا بالصلاة.